So hey guys, welcome back to Love Triangle. I think His Little Secret is what the story, the side, what is it called? Spin-off story is called. But yeah, let us go. I've like gained so much because I could have recorded yesterday, but I wasn't really in the mood, so I just continued playing the games. But anyways, let's go. Yes, I wonder if I'll be able to finish this before, because I have literally like a few hours left before this thing ends. Hey Naoki. Naoki returns Cody's cheerful greeting with a faint nod. Then, following a brief glance in my direction, he enters his room. What's up with him? I am so confused right now because I'm reading like 4 stories. That sounds so insane, but yeah. And one of them is also Naoki's main story. So that's why I'm so confused. I don't even know what happened last with him. Cody asks curiously after waiting for Naoki's door to completely close. Did something happen between you two? What? Oh, now I remember. Okay, I remember where we are. Why do you ask? That didn't feel right. He barely even looked at you. Oh my god. I guess it's bad enough even you can't tell, huh? Oh no, my voice is beginning to shake. I quickly lower my head, hoping to hide my expression. Listen, Livia, do you mind if we step into your room for a moment? Cody? In response to Cody's kind consideration, I force myself to look up at him. I like to tell him then. Yeah, let's just tell him, whatever. Hopefully these choices don't weigh anything. That's why I like these stories, but anyways. Cody considered concern about me and Naoki isn't he. Asking to step into my room is his way of telling me he's willing to talk about it. Well, will he really listen to my troubles? After seeing Naoki's demeanor a moment ago, I feel like my heart is never near its breaking point. Maybe talking with someone will be more productive than worrying about it all on my own. Having their calm perspective might keep me from simply becoming more and more negative. I'll do anything to keep Naoki and myself together. Only I doubt Naoki would appreciate me discussing with someone else. Indecision causes me to hesitate. Okay then, I'll let myself in. Cody pushes my door open and drags me inside. Wait, Cody. We certainly can't talk in the hallway. He replies the wink. And you're better off sitting on the sofa if you're going to fret over whatever it is. Having said that, he firmly shuts the door. I end up talking to Cody about what has happened between Naoki and myself. And now I'm starting to lose confidence in our relationship. So something bothering him that he won't talk to you about. And he's even gone so as far as to give you the brush off. And now all... Oh no! Someone is calling, but... I don't know. I'll answer later after this. And he's even gone as far as to give you the brush off, and now all of that got you really worried. Yeah, who knows, maybe I'm just overreacting. Josh recommended I wait until Naoki is ready to talk. That sounds just like him. I think I can't see why you'll be feeling anxious though. People want their partners to feel comfortable sharing their troubles and not just bottling them up inside. That's what I think. However, in Naoki's case, he doesn't really express his emotions, does he? He's always so quiet and reserved. That's why I was so startled when he gave me the brush off like that. It seems like people from Kaio City have a tendency not to let their emotions show, and Naoki is a good example. It must be part of their culture background. But I'm your freaking boy girlfriend. I guess if you think of it from Naoki's standpoint, he might find your behavior rather surprising sometimes. True. Who knows, maybe he's simply having trouble talking to you because you're a girl. I could try asking him. We know he's probably in his room right now. But Cody, oh my god. Besides, I could care less if he gives me the cold shoulder. Let me go fill him out for you. But if you guys get into a fight or something, it will be all my fault. Relax, listen. Naoki's attitude has you feeling really anxious at the moment, right? And yet I'll bet you've covered up those feelings with your concern for him. When I don't think on one member of a couple should constantly be concealing their feelings like that. Exactly. Cody gives me a reassuring pat on the shoulder. So I'll go to have a chat with Naoki and I will see you afterwards, okay? Okay, guys, I'll be right back, and it seems to be a challenge. But I'll be right back. I just need to call back the person who was calling me. But yeah, I'll be back in a sec. Okay, guys. I am back, and I had a very awesome conversation with my mom. But anyways, let's not get off topic. Let's get back to this. Cody? Because this is a hard decision. I'm just gonna tell him, I don't know. Let's just say it. Without thinking, I called out to stop Cody. I'm glad Cody is willing to help, but I know how sensitive Naoki can be. If Cody goes barging in asking Naoki questions, it might make things worse. No matter how hard I try, my thoughts grow more and more negative. Cody, wait, give me a chance to think things through. Livia, I know you're worried, but don't you think you're letting your worries hinder you just a little? His remark catches me by surprise. I suppose he might have a point. Listen, Livia, I want to see you smile again. I may not be your steady boyfriend, but I still like you a lot. Cody, he's one of my favorites, my dear. And as your friend, I want to help you just as much as any boyfriend would. It's so weird. Okay, this is not the time to explain. But let me just explain. If you don't want to listen, I guess you can't skip this part. But yeah, I feel like I never really choose people like Cody. But then, I don't know. He was the first person I ended up. Like, the funny thing is I went for Ryan. But I think I mentioned this before in one of my videos. Oh, it was on my live stream. But yes, I've gone for Ryan. But then I actually fell for Cody. So that's just weird. Because he's childish and that bubbly kind of kid that I never really go for in these kind of stories. But yeah. Anyways. Thanks so much. So you just leave Naoki to me, okay? And while I'm gone, you should rest a bit before dinner. You look tired. After that final suggestion, Cody departs. I let out a deep sigh. It's kind of a relief talking to Cody and having him offer to step in. And I think he's right. All this worrying may have worn me out. I should probably lie down and rest. If I don't want people to be concerned when they see me at dinner, I lie down on the bed and close my eyes, preparing to take a nap. However, how can I sleep when I can't stop thinking about Naoki? My thoughts keep racing. For instance, I remember Naoki teaching me calligraphy. I love when he smiles, he's so cute. Okay, sorry. Livia, stop tensing your shoulder. I can't help it. I'm nervous. He's sitting so close behind me. He's practically hugging me as he watches my hands. Try and relax your arms. Your characters will come out croaky if you strain so hard. Relax? But it's hard. It's hard trying to write when my arms held out like this. You might be holding the brush too tight. Oh. Yikes, I think my heart started racing when he placed his hand on top of mine just now. If Naoki notices, it will be so embarrassing. Your calligraphy is very mentulous and full of warmth, Livia. It is? People's characters show through in their brush strokes. When I turn to Naoki, to look at Naoki, he gazes affectionately back. Back to me. Will Naoki still see my calligraphy is meticulous and full of warmth if he saw it now? The memories keep coming. When the two of us went shopping together, how I held his arm as he casually escorted me, how he initially intentively listened to my stories. Naoki, every thought of you reminds me of how much I... Next thing I realized, I was waking up and the room is dark. Apparently, I had managed to fall asleep. I'm waking up. What is the time? I quickly glance at my phone, realize dinner is about to start. Revealed? What? Okay, hold on. It looks like... Oh, a quick glance on my phone. Revealed dinner is about to start. Okay, I just had to read that again. That sentence felt so weird. It looks like Cody hasn't tried to contact me. I wonder how his talk with Naoki went. It concerns me there is no news from Cody. However, I feel bad pestering him after placing my trust in him. Perhaps I should just head to the cafe. I stop and place my hand on my stomach. Curious, would have imagined I'll be hungry at a... Curious, who would have imagined I'll be... hungry at a time like this. Maybe the nap had helped lift my spirit a little. I then climb out of bed and make my way to the cafe. Ah, that's strange. Is there nobody here? To my surprise, when I arrive at the cafe for dinner, the place is quiet. Josh isn't even here. It seems really odd he'll be gone at this hour. I was looking forward to his great cooking, but it seems like I'll have to fix something myself. What sounds good? Woof! Doing this dog sometimes, it's so weird. Lucas, who it turns out is quietly scrabbled out on the carpet, startles me by barking in reply to my muttering. Oh, hey, Lucas. Are you the only one here? I crouch down and begin petting him vigorously around his head and neck. What's this? When my hand reaches his neck, I feel something unusual. I wonder what it could be. It is attached to his collar. A letter? My name is written on it in meticulously executed handwriting. Naoki's handwriting? What? I waste no time opening it up. Please come up to the second floor of the cafe. I nearly crumbled the short note as I excitedly clench my fist. I've got no idea what Naoki could be thinking at the moment, but I'm thrilled he's reached out to me. Even though Carlo hasn't contacted me, maybe he succeeded in swaying Naoki's feelings a little. Yeah, this has to be Cody's doing. But let's just get excited and go. I can't let this chance get away. The note gives no indication of what Naoki might want. However, if he's willing to talk to me and not just give me the brush off. What am I waiting for? I've got to go upstairs. Get upstairs. I can't stand this any longer. Our relationship feels so awkward and unpleasant right now. Cody has earned my gratitude. I give Lucas one last stroke, then rise to my feet. Obviously, I'm heading up to the second floor. Oh my god, what's gonna happen? What is your secret? I love this place. Oh my god, it's just the most awesome view. Like, look at that. When I reach the... And this place just has seen so many of my memories, but anyways. When I reach the top of the stairs, I find Naoki quietly waiting with the beautiful nighttime view at his backdrop. Naoki? He turns towards me when I call out, and his expression looks apologetic. I notice the glass table in front of him is laid out with plates of food. Wow, that looks like quite a spread. And if I'm not mistaken, it's Kayo City cuisine. I've been waiting for you. Oh my god. He appears calm, although perhaps a little stiff, as he quietly stares and reaches out with his hand. Is he nervous? I briefly glance down at it while the thought crosses my mind. Is it possible he's just as upset about our situation as I am and hoping to make up? I muster up the courage to take a step towards him and grab the offering hand. Oh. He gently, almost protectively, gives my hand a squeeze. My heart leaps. Forgive me, Livia. He wraps both my hands around his hands around mine and whispers. A lot has happened between us since you arrived here at Lilac Court, and I feel incredibly lucky to have fallen in love with you. I mean that from the bottom of my heart. Naoki? I stare back at him in surprise. What is he trying to say? Hearing him suddenly start talking about our history like this makes it sound like... Ah! No! To propose! But proposes... Those are two extremes! Oh my god, I just say propose. What? Naoki? What's gotten into you all of a sudden? Naoki lowers his gaze. It sounds like he's trying to propose to me. I continue to stare at him. No, he won't propose at a time like this, will he? Which only leaves... Oh my god. My chest grows tight. I desperately fight back a sense of forlornness that threatens to bring me to tears. Livia? Naoki calls out and sounds concerned. Oh my god, what? I should have enough, yes? I have overplayed those games. I could actually finish it before the 18th ends. Before 11 reaches. What time is it right now? Oh my god. What's wrong? What's wrong? I could ask you the same thing. My lips tremble as I struggle to control my emotions. It sounds to me like you're trying to sort out your feelings. Why? Because I don't know how else to talk to you if I don't. Are you trying to decide how you feel about me, about our relationship? I continue to question Naoki all the while, fearing every thought I utter will turn into reality. I can't stand this any longer. I have to know the truth. Our relationship. What are you talking about? Naoki looks at me suspiciously. You want to make a clean break, don't you? Is that what this fancy meal is for? My tone turns accusatory, as I glance at all the dishes he has arranged. Even if Naoki were mad at me, he wouldn't air all his grievances then angrily storm off like some person. If he's going to break up with me, this is exactly how he'll do it, as cleanly and elegantly as he possibly can. Livia, don't tell me. I guess I'm just too offended about my feelings for someone who likes to hide theirs. Is that it? Oh my god. Livia, wait, I think you're mistaken. Naoki surprises me by raising his voice for once. He looks pale. I am? Yes. He nods. The thought of questioning my feelings for you. For you or our relationship never crossed my mind. If anything, I was thinking of us. I was trying to understand why I'm such a coward. A coward? What do you mean? I'm a coward for hurting you, simply because some little thing upset me. What upset you? After holding my hand between his all this time, he now lifts it up to my cheek. He handles it almost as it were some priceless treasure. You tried to talk to me earlier and I refused you. Will you still listen now? With that look of sincerity in your eyes, how can I say no? Thanks. Naoki's expression softens and he finally appears to relax. I quietly let him escort me by my arm. Oh my god, I'm gonna finish this. I don't know why I feel like crying right now. Oh, don't ask me why. I just have so many emotions right now. I need to relax. Oh, I hope you don't mind. I hope you don't mind talking before we eat. That's fine. We sit down beside one another on the couch and he puts his arm around my shoulder. This is embarrassing to admit, but earlier today I was really angry with myself. I didn't want you to notice though, and I think that's why I lashed out at you. I'm sorry. Naoki looks deeply apologetic as he lowers his gaze. I didn't realize what a horrible person I had been until Cody came in and explained how badly I had hurt you. I really feel bad about that. Try not to be too upset. I probably let it bother me a little more than I should have. All the guilt and sorrow I hear in Naoki's voice compels me to respond in his defense. I'm not used to seeing you get angry like that. You're always so calm and relaxed. I think that's what really upset me. I certainly can't think straight now. It's not like Naoki to become emotional. Seeing him react like that made me uneasy. You think I would understand my boyfriend, but suddenly an almost trivial remark seemed to turn him into a complete stranger. I'm really sorry. None of this would have happened if I hadn't been upset in the first place. I explained how I feel to others isn't my strong point, and it's become obvious I need to make an effort at it, much so than other people. I have no idea how disappointed I was in myself when Cody explained to me how sad I had made you feel. Speaking of Cody, why haven't I heard from him? He offered to explain everything to you for me if I thought it would help, but I told him I'll manage on my own. In the meantime, I asked him not to contact you until we had a chance to talk. No wonder. That's why I never heard back from him. He was trying to respect Naoki's wishes. I'm really grateful to Cody and to you too, Naoki. Me? I haven't done anything to earn your gratitude. So, sure you have. You're doing it right now by trying to explain your emotions even though it's difficult for you. Not to mention you've arranged this incredible feast. What's the story behind that? One of my supporters who happened to be from Kayo City runs a restaurant here in Kaleido City. He was kind enough to prepare all of these Kayo City dishes for me. I asked him for food people commonly eat when they're outside parties and admiring the cherry blossoms. That's wonderful. That's a wonderful sounding custom. I'm glad you think so, Olivia. Naoki squeezes me tightly in his arms. Oh my god. I can't believe I'm finishing this before. You and I have been dating for 4 months now. It's just been 4 months. Come to think of it. It suddenly dawns on me that today marks our four-month anniversary. We have both been so busy with work, we have failed to celebrate any of our previous monthly anniversaries. That's why I told myself we would celebrate this one. However, I got distracted arranging my exhibition and realized today had crept up on me before I could plan anything. You're kidding. Naoki was hoping to celebrate our anniversary. I never would have guessed. I stare at him in surprise. I noticed the date while we were watching Okay. Makes sense I got pissed. I noticed the date while we were watching television earlier and got really mad at myself of letting such an important day slip my mind. I'm so sorry. Such a little thing like that. Oh my god. That must have been why I had him sigh. Well, I wish you hadn't let it upset you. Exactly. I know how busy you've been lately. I wanted our anniversary to be a changing point for me. After all, I've realized how my nature can sometimes make you uneasy. Now, okay. I want to respond only, I'm so full of emotion right now, I don't know what to say. I'm well aware of how shy Naoki is, which makes his desire to change for my sake that much more appreciated. And as awkward as he may be, I can still sense how deep his affection for me lies. I was going to surprise you today by opening up and telling you exactly how I feel. Only I didn't even manage to do that. Instead, I got angry and annoyed with myself. I managed to upset you in the process. Talk about shameful. For all my faults, are you still willing to have me? I love you, Naoki. I don't see any faults when I look at you. I wrap my arms around him. I see a deeply passionate man hiding beneath a shy exterior. And the effort that man is making now explains his feeling for me is more than appreciated. After all, you just told me you wanted to change for me. Find me any other man who is willing to do that. Thank you, Livia. Your kindness is always a blessing to me. Overwhelmed by his emotion, Naoki strongly embraces me. If I wish to discuss our future together, will you still listen to me? Obviously. Who else would I talk to? We gaze into each other's eyes and the rest of the world around us seems to fade away. Checkpoint! I think it's the end, right? Yes! I'll get Tiny Naoki. Let's see, what's his end? Yeah, definitely not getting that. Mm-mm. No, no. Oh, yeah, I have to do that on my phone. Keep on forgetting. Oh, wait. I'll be back in a second. Okay, guys. I am going to end here because it's already 27 minutes. I didn't even realize how far in I had gone into the recording. But yes, it's probably going to be more than that since I'll put the first part with this. But yes, thanks for watching and I hope you enjoy this little secret that Naoki was hiding. And let's see the finale next episode. Toodles!